with the prayer. सहनावतु सहनो भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। Before we start, I will go back to the question we had selected in the month of July for the master group discussion. Some of you have joined that session last Sunday of July. We could not take this question because we ran out of time. But when we were discussing the question that came from the Bhagavad Gita Kannada group, on the Buddhi Yukta Karma, that chapter 2, verse 50 from the Bhagavad Gita, that was a long discussion and answer was quite long. And many parts of these questions got addressed in that question itself. So the question what we had gathered from our group was, is on your screen, like what is intellect? And some of you have given your comments on this question in the group. And also there was a discussion on what is the difference between intellect and intelligence? Is there a difference? If yes, then what is the difference? And how can one become more intellectual? All these koshas, what we discussed in the last lecture, Vigyanmay kosha, Manomay kosha, there was good discussion around these things. So just taking some snippets from the answer that came in the master group discussion was intellect. When we talk about intellect, there are three layers of it. The three levels of it were discussed. The very basic level or the very first level is the level of information. What we normally call as the gross intellect, or we call as the intelligence, the information, the data which we gather. Okay. The knowledge of the things around us, the knowledge of the world around us, that's the lower level of the intellect. At that level, gross intellect, the basic discrimination capacities are there, where we say that something is hot, something is cold, it is day and then it is night. These kind of very, very early level of basic level of discrimination capacity, which even animals also have some level at some level, animals also have that kind of capacity. And the second level is where intellect, when we are talking more about the sadvivek, it is known as sadvivek, where the discrimination capacity further gets refined. And the awareness with the level, the awareness is growing, the light of consciousness is guiding light over there, and it is giving some level of clarity. We are able to see what the behind the visible at that point. Okay, so we see the action which is happening. Some people take action, their decisions, or they form their judgment basis on what they are seeing only. Okay, what is happening and what is the action. And then they say that this is a good action or it is a bad action. But what is behind that action? What is the intent? The performer of the action, what is he having in the behind the action intent? Actually, that determines whether that is a good action or that is a bad action. So with more or the deeper level of awareness, we are able to read behind the scenes. Okay, we are able to see what is coming in the future. So as the intellect and the awareness is growing, we are developing that sort of capacity, and based on that, we are able to discriminate between what is right, what is wrong at that stage. At that level, emotions are not driving the actions, because when emotions are driving the actions, then it is more of an illusion. That is what which was discussed. It leads to illusion, and that action will come as a detached attached action, because emotions will bind you to the action. Those will not be the impersonal action. That will be very personalized action, and biased actions will come when the intellectual level is not fully grown at that level. So, and then the third level is the highest level of intellect, where the ability reaches to the level where one is able to distinguish between what is real and what is unreal. Okay. When we go back to that statement of Brahma Satya Jagat Mithya, when somebody reaches at that level and able to experience that particular statement, understand that particular statement, that is the level of highest level of intellect is there, which is called as Sukshma Sad Vivek, Pragya Vivek. Different terminologies are given to that. So that is more or less how one can become more intellectual. Again, the light of consciousness is there in everybody. Like light of sun is always there, and it is doing its job. So light of consciousness, intellect is there, already there. It is not something which is not there and one has to start developing it. But what is happening is that envelope of ignorance which is there, the impurities which are formed on the mental plane, they obstruct this light, due to which the clarity is not coming in our actions, in our thoughts, anywhere. The clarity is not coming. We remain delusioned. Okay, so this is what which was there. So if we have to develop our intellectual capacity, it is important that this envelope has to be of ignorance, envelope of impurity has to be removed through sadhanas, through purifications. There are various techniques of purifications are there. Sadhana and satsang, these are the two wheels using which you can grow and then grow, have more of your intellectual capacity, the light of intellect falling on your manomaya kosha and then on your annamaya kosha, where the actions are performed. So quickly, just to summarize, and I hope this gives clarity about this question. Now we will move to the topic we have for this month, which is gross body. And I think this is something we have all studied, a lot of these things. If you take a look at cells, we have all studied in our school time, in biology chapters and all, right? So I'm not going to touch more upon those aspects because they are available everywhere. We have gone through it. I'll quickly touch upon that, spend few minutes, and then we'll go to basically the process of manifestation. From how the manifestation is taking place from the sukshma to sthul, from subtle to gross. And then, of course, a very important part of the gross body is it is performing the actions. And karma yoga is very, very deeper level of things. So we will go through few universal laws of the actions, if time permits today. So if we recall this picture where matter and consciousness combined to form this life which takes place, matter manifests and if we segment this matter to see our personality, So there are three important parts of the personality: body, mind, and intellect. And gross body is where the Annamaya Kosha, we're talking about Annamaya Kosha, five sense organs and the five motor organs, the five Gyanendriyas and the five Karmendriyas, which are there, which performs the, which takes the input of the world, and then they perform the output. They show the output of the decision which is taken by the processor inside the body. That processor is the Manomaya Kosha and the Vigyanmaya Kosha. The mind and the intellect together, they do process the input and produce the output, which is performed by the body. Body is nothing but just like a receiver of the command and then performs that command. Nothing more than that. Okay. And that is why in lot of scriptures, it has been described as a field. It is like a made up of field. What is there inside the body? It is made up of field only. Shankaracharya, in many of his texts or other sages, they have clearly defined it as a field. But the main thing we have to see is how much focus we are giving on our body these days. A lot of investment we do on our body. We think that this body is everything. This body is the reality because we can perceive it, we can touch it, we can smell it, we can feel it. Throughout the life, all our activities, most of our activities are governed, are directed towards the taking care of this body only. There is very, very low focus on the main part of the thing, the processor part, which is there in our personality. Because that is something which is subtle. And we don't get more experience of the subtle. Okay. But what our sages are saying, this is a field. You are spending large part of your life, you are investing large part of your life only to know this field. They are not rejecting the benefit. They are not rejecting or the downplaying the significance of the body. The significance of the body is there. It helps you. It is like a vehicle. It is a vehicle which will help you to reach the destination. Without this body, one cannot reach. The processor cannot function. Okay. So processor needs the body to function. But again, we have to remember that this is not everything. This is just a tip of the iceberg. And then we have to decide, we have to use our intellect, how much focus we should give on the body. And where we have to put more of our investment in terms of time, investment in terms of money, any kind of resources to develop our personality. Just by looking good doesn't mean that the personality is good. So it is a bundle of skin, flesh, blood, bones, which is there. And once the life is over, everything goes back into the five elements from where it has come. Okay. Now the unit of the body, as we have studied, we all very well know, it is the cell. A human body contains approximately 100 trillions of cells which are there. I have a very brief video, two and a half minute video, which shows a beautiful graphics about the cell. Let me just bring it up.
Thank you.
Okay. So, as I said, I'm not going to spend too much time. This is all intelligence, which we have, information, which we have all studied a lot. It's an interesting topic. A lot of things happens inside that tiny cells, as it was showing. 10,000, more than 10,000 cells can sit on the tip of the needle. Such a small, small thing, but it creates this wonderful body for us. And inside this tiny thing, so many reactions and processes and actions are happening. Transactions per second, if you see, a wonderful, wonderful instrument of the nature. The cell, basically, if we talk about cell, four basic parameters. It is like a laboratory. You know? So many chemical reactions are happening, and what we see that hydration, that means water level, is important inside the cell. Then there is a pH value. Every cell has a pH value of it. It determines whether the cell is acidic or cell is alkaline. Human body is cells. The normal pH value of human body is in the alkaline state. It is 7 point, little bit above the 7. 7 is the pH value of water. But normally, due to our lifestyle, whatever we are eating, and the spicy and others, for the impurities which we carry inside us, our body normally slips into the pH level below 7. The body tends to be more acidic in nature. The cell becomes acidic. Okay. Temperature. Every cell, there is an Agni Tattva, the fire element is there, which maintains the temperature inside the cell. Due to the presence of that temperature, cellular metabolism is taking place. If this temperature goes up and down, there will be disturbances in the cell. And of course, there is a light. Light here means the memory, the information that the cell carries. Okay, that means the light. Every cell has a light inside it. It has a memory inside it. It is carrying the information. Okay, these are four basic parameters. And if you see, they are related to the five elements, because cell is nothing. When a body's unit is cell, what is the unit of cell is the elements, the five elements, which is what we will discuss briefly. An interesting phenomenon takes place inside the cell. It has an effect of solar and lunar influence on it. When the sun is rising, there will be effect on the cells. And when the sun sets, when the moon is there, it has a different effect on the cells. So if we take a look at the normal cell activity during the daytime, so you see here four important elements are here: sodium, calcium, magnesium, and potassium. So when the day happens, during the daytime, the solar influences, sodium and calcium will move inside the cell. And magnesium and potassium, it will displace. They will move out of the cell. Okay. And then the energy which is needed for us to do the work, due to movement of sodium and calcium inside, the energy process in the cell is taking place. And when the sun sets, the reverse process happens, because the body becomes tired, the energy has been spent, body needs some relaxation. So during the night time when we are sleeping, body tries to repair itself, refresh itself. Sodium and calcium will move out. Magnesium and potassium move back into the cell, and they do the repairing job during the night. That is how the process, this wonderful process, goes on. And whatever little energy we need to maintain and sustain this body, it takes place because of the influence of solar and lunar activity. So this happens in the normal circumstances for a normal cell. In the next chart, we will understand the importance of water. As we talked about hydration, 70% of the cell is water. So when the hydration or the water element is disturbed, if the water element goes low, so what happens normally is, if you see in the that round circular cell is there, during the night time, a cholesterol lipid membrane is formed around the body, because the cell is not allowing the more water to flow out of it. It tries to retain water because the water level is going down. It tries to conserve more water. And to conserve that, it will create a layer of cholesterol lipid membrane around it, due to which the movement of those elements, the sodium and calcium, are not able to go out, and magnesium and potassium are not able to come inside it due to that. And it is not happening. That means some abnormality is happening. And the body, when we get up in the morning, we will be tired because the whole repair process has not been completed, as the movement has been obstructed by this cholesterol layer, which is formed. So just for this information, some, this was some interesting information I got, I thought of sharing with you about the cell and how important it is to keep the cells hydrated, remain the water level over there. So if we go inside the cell, you know, there is a nucleus inside the cell, there are chromosomes, there are genes, DNA, which is carrying all the information, not from this birth, but also from the past births also. It is like a black box of an aeroplane, which keeps all the recording of the flight. So whatever life we take, that all, everything gets recorded inside this. And still a lot of research needs to happen on the DNA. DNA, we say that it is made up of 12 strands. It is a double helical structure with 12 strands. There was a team of scientists which tried to figure out the information which is there inside this. They tried to study the DNA and they tried to study the patterns. They could study only in the first two layers of the patterns. Some patterns are there recording. They could not study, or they could not reach, or they could not decipher in the remaining 10 layers which are there. So that team rejected. They said that these are like the junk layers. There is nothing over there. The information is there only in the two layers. But that is not the case, because it's like the grapes are sour kind of thing. If you are not able to reach, that doesn't mean that information does not exist in those 12 layers. Nature never creates anything which has no use. If it has given 12 layers to the DNA, there must be some use. It must be playing some role. There must be some purpose of it. Then another team of scientists, I believe they were from Russia, they took up this study further. And in their team, they also included a linguistic person who is more knowledgeable in the field of languages and impressions, was also included in that team. And they could figure out certain patterns in the lower layers of the DNA also. And they told that no, they proved it. They are not the junk layers. There are impressions and there are patterns which are there. So the modern science is trying to figure out the mysteries which are there behind the DNA. A lot has to be still explored, and the research has to go on in that area. So, and then you all know, then we have atoms. There are atoms, and inside the atoms, there are subatomic particles. In the nucleus of the atom, there is proton, there are neutrons, there are bosons, there are muons. and then electrons are moving around the atoms, similar to how the planets are revolving around the sun. If sun is a nucleus, the planets are moving around it. Similarly, electrons are moving around that inside the body. So the entire whatever is outside is inside also. The same phenomena is taking place inside the body. We are organic. Our body is organic in nature. Organic means a large part of our body, 99% of our body is made up of three important elements here, hydrogen, oxygen, and carbon. Okay. You can see the percentage of these. 65% it is hydrogen, 25% is oxygen, and 9% it is carbon. Remaining 1% is all other elements, what we talk about. So predominantly 99% it is carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, which is there. Is atom is the smallest part. We have studied about the states of matter, solid, liquid, gas, and plasma in our schooling days. This has been taught to us. And then came the quantum layer in the late 19th century. These discoveries happened, electron, proton, neutrons, and this discovery is still going on. But go back, if we go back to the scriptures, they are talking much beyond that, that what is beyond this quantum layer is the metaphysical layer, which is of the five elements, earth, water, fire, air, and space. And these come from the five rudimentary elements of smell, taste, form, touch, and sound. Shabd, sparsha, roop, ras, gandh. These are called the tanmatras. And prithvi, apo, tejo, vayu, akash, earth, water, fire, air, space, they are called the tattvas, the five fundamental elements. So the gross body is made up of, the unit of the gross body is these five elements. And then beyond, if we go in the subtle realm, it is energy, and then, you know, energy again, physical and subtle energies are there. The physical form of the energy, which you can perceive, the subtle form of the energy, which you cannot perceive through your senses. The cosmic energy, the prana, the pranamaya kosha, those energies which are also there functioning inside the body. And then, of course, the three gunas of sattva, rajas, tamas have enveloped everything into it. So this entire structure determines the personality of us, the personality what we have. Now, this is important to know how the process of manifestation takes place from the tanmatras to the tattvas. If we go back to the modern science, when we talk at the level of cell, we know that cells, the division and multiplication of the cells takes place inside the body. As this division and multiplication takes place, the various structures are formed and it causes some results to come out. Similarly, in the metaphysical layer and in the subtle layer, this multiplication and division process takes place. And this process has been called as Panchikaranam. In the Vedanta sciences, this has been called as a Panchikaranam. This process is given in Vivek Chudamani by Adi Shankaracharya. So what happens here? How this multiplication and division taking place in the Panchikaranam? Let us see that. So what you see on your screen now are the tanmatras, are the rudimentary elements. These rudimentary elements form the subtle body, sukshma sharir of us. Shabda, sparsha, roopa, rasa, gandha. These are the sense objects, tanmatras. Okay, they form the subtle body of us, sukshma sharir. So here, the manifestation happens when the multiplication and division is happening. Now what you will see on your screen, number 2, step number 2 and number 3, each tanmatra divides itself into two equal parts, 50%, 50%. So tanmatra of space 50%, and then tanmatra, there are two halves of it. Similarly, tanmatra of air, which is touch, sparsha. Tanmatra of fire is the rupa, form. Again, it also divides into two. Tanmatra of water is rasa. Tanmatra of earth is gandh, smell. Okay. So, TS, TA, TF, TW, TE. I have used, so S stands for space, A stands for air, F stands for fire, W stands for water, and E stands for earth. Okay. So, these are the tanmatras. In the next stage, what happens? One half of 50% remains same. No change there. The 50% of tanmatra remains same. The second half further divides into four equal parts. That is 12.5% of space plus 12.5%. You can see the four parts it has got divided. So each tanmatra will undergo this kind of division into it. Okay, so this is happening in the fourth step inside as the process of manifestation is now going on. And in the final stage, you see the 50% of tanmatra of each element, it takes one eighth, that is 12.5% of tanmatra from each of the other elements. So on the first, if you see 50% plus 12.5% of touch, 12.5% of form, 12.5% of rasa, that is taste, and 12.5% of smell. This goes on to make the space element, the first you see. Second you see, similarly, goes on to make the air element, then fire element, then water element, and the earth element. Now it is taking the grossification is happening. The subtle is converting into gross. It is showing itself more gross through the process of panchikaranam. This is how the five elements are formed. And these five elements then further create this entire body for us. Okay. All the parts which are having this holes, nasal cavity, the things are there, ears are there, anus, they represent everything. There is space. 99.9% of our body is space by means of volume, not by means of mass, by means of volume. And then air element, as we all know, it is there. We are taking inside oxygen, and there are number of gases, nitrogen, hydrogen, carbon dioxide. There is a life force which is there, the subtle part of the air element which is inside. This again, prana divides into five parts, panch prana, and then panch up prana are also there. They help in performing the various physiological function that happens inside the body. Okay, so that is the air element. The fire element, which maintains the temperature in the body, and water element, which is there, 70% of the body is water. And we just discussed how important the hydration level for the body. And of course, the earth element, which forms the annamaya kosha, the gross body, mainly by means of mass, earth element is largest over there, but not by the volume, by mass. Okay, so this is the process of panchikaranam that takes place. So again, you see that tanmatras, five, they combine to form the elements, and these elements then combine to form the gross body, which has the panch gyanendriyas, that is the sense organs, and the panchkarmendriyas, which are the motor organs which are there. These sense objects, with the sense organs, these sense objects bind the person to the worldly things which are there. Okay, these sense objects create the attachment for us, and we create our own attachment, and we create our own foundations through these sense. These sense objects are not outside, they are inside. These are the sensory centers in the manomay kosha which are there. They create the attachment towards the world, and we get inside this web which is created by us only. I don't think we will be able to finish today, because now we are getting into the dharma of act body, which is the action, karma. Dharma of the body is the karma, it performs the action. It will take about 30-40 minutes. So what we will do, we will pick this topic for the next session. And today's session, we will just close here with this intelligent or the information which is there about the cell. And the most important part that we discussed today is the process of panchikarana. Okay. So we will meet next Sunday to have discussion around these areas, what the topics we discussed. And then we will get into the actions into the next month, in the month of September. I thank you for your time, and we will do the prayer to close the session. Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Thank you very much. Over to you, Prashantji.
Thank you, Anuragbhaiya. Thank you all to join this call. So we will meet next Sunday for this group discussion based on the same topic we discussed today. So we will send you the link, and you will get the recordings as well. So till that time, stay safe. You all have a great day. Okay? We can end the meeting over here. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
धन्यवाद सर, बहुत बहुत मजा आया।